Greetings and welcome back, mechanics, to Scrap Mechanic and to our scissor lift car thing. In this episode, I am going to be tidying up this design. We're going to be getting rid of the majority of the warning cubes, as you can see here, and replacing them with different types of props or just different types of blocks as a whole, and generally smartening up this design a little bit. But I'm also going to take the opportunity to demonstrate a couple of the things that have been suggested in the comments of the last video. Now, the first one, easily the most popular one, was asking me to set this up. Two engines. Now I'm going to show you why I didn't do that originally. There we go. Now, if it would spin like that, that would be perfect, but it won't. If I turn this on even to the lowest level, that's how fast it spins. It is spinning so fast you can barely see the fact that it's spinning. It's glitchy by comparison. So it has to be a control, unfortunately. I wish it could be something else, but it's not going to be happening, I'm afraid. Let's see, is that all done? Good, good, good. Yes, yes, yes. Fantastic. Now, I may even get rid of the lights, honestly. As nice as they are, having the control just making noise all the time is remarkably annoying. I've also gotten rid of the suspension at the back, you may notice, simply because having a suspension on this vehicle, considering how heavy it is, really tanks the FPS. And it does it because the way suspension works is when it's compressed, the computer is performing quite heavy calculations on how this suspension should be interacting with the world, what kind of forces it should be applying to the vehicle or absorbing from the vehicle, so on and so forth. So when it's under a high state of compression all the time, it just tanks your FPS because your computer's having to do so much more thinking. So I've gotten rid of that, and instead we'll just have a solid limp. But that is enough waffling on from me. I do have a bit of a cold today, so I do apologize if throughout this video you do hear me snuffle a little bit here and there. I will do my best not to let that get in the way. But I think it's time for us to begin the beautification process. We'll be right back. Okay. I was thinking about possibly building up more of a casing for the engine, but I think that's actually sufficient for now. The lift is going to pose more of a problem because much of the lift was built into these blocks, so to change that would be very difficult at this stage. However, what I could do instead is perhaps just lay down the groundwork to make it look a little bit more electrical in a way, get a little bit more detailing on it, also switching out some of these blocks for just regular metal blocks, that sort of thing. Might even be able to find a use for that as well. We're definitely going to be keeping hold of this too. I'm additionally thinking of adding in some sort of stairs, because as you can see now, I've stabilized the vehicle when it's propped up. So having a stairs up would actually be really, really nice. Maybe I could make a stairs of these sorts of things and just kind of have them fold out from underneath. Ooh, that's a good idea, actually. Or I could use these components, for example. You know what? We'll pop that there. Yeah, I actually quite like that being there. Gives it a little bit more character on that side. Little fuel tank at the back as well, you know, just for reasons. We will get rid of this on both sides. And then I've got to work out how I'm going to build this in without causing too much trouble for the main build. Because that does not give me enough room to really fit too much in there.
Thank you.
Okay, there we go. I think I've put enough just random bits and bobs on this now that I'm happy with the way it looks. It does restrict the angle from which you can enter the control component of the vehicle, but on the whole, I'm not too displeased with that, honestly. It should be easy enough to get on, even when it's fully extended. In fact, let's give that a try. I know it's possible to get on it when it's only partially extended, but getting on it when it's fully extended may, in fact, be quite a bit more difficult, especially if you're not actually next to a building as I am now. So, let's jump down and see how easy it would be to get back up there. Not easy at all. However, the switches are down here. Now, that is why I actually moved the switches to the bottom, so that I could, in a pinch, use these to get up to the to control the cab. So that's fine. Got loads of lights all over the place. It doesn't wobble when I try to steer it like a derp when I'm actually in the cab. And you can get up here and you can walk around a little bit. It's still a little bit unclean, but up there it's a tad messy, I suppose. I was thinking more of having this as an actual built-over engine area, but you know what? I actually kind of like it the way it is right now. It looks a little bit more industrial in a way. Now, I was thinking about adding stairs, but honestly, the wheels themselves become just as good as stairs once they're going. So let's take this somewhere else for now. Let's just go ahead and reverse. There we go. It does not move very fast because this is a fairly heavy vehicle, all things told. In fact, let's just increase the engine power just a tad, shall we? Let's pop this up to about there and see how that goes. Now, we should easily be able to get on from here. Okay, that's a lot faster than I was expecting, honestly. Okay. I really do wish there was some sort of smokestack kind of component that I could put it on the back. But in the end, I just went for the curved duct sections. Simply because at least they look a little bit more different from the valves. The valves certainly don't look like smokestacks. But I was just trying to cap those pipes off with something. Ideally, some sort of exhaust would have been cool, but that'll do. Okay, I'm fairly happy with how this is controlling. I'm doing things that would normally have tipped over one of my other bots. So the fact that this is managing it so well bodes well for this little vehicle. Okay, I think this build is now complete. So, as I mentioned, we're going to be moving on to the base. At least I think I mentioned it. I may not have. In which case, we're going to be moving on to the base now. Specifically, onto the home. Okay. Welcome back. We are going to continue with this episode in the home base. And specifically, the first thing we really need to do is not build a door on the toilet. That you might think it would be the first thing we need to do, but it's actually not. You can trust me. We need to get up to the second level. Now, there are a number of ways that we could do this. We could have stairs rising up from the ground, stairs just here permanently. But I would actually like some stairs that fold out of the wall. Now, there's a couple of ways that we're going to be able to achieve this, and I kind of have settled on one in particular. This is our goal. We want to get up to there. Now, how are we going to do that? You may be asking yourself, and you are right to ask that question. The main way would be, let's see, I want a step every two tiles, basically. So we're going to want one there, and we're just going to bring this all the way down. This is going to act as the point that we can use for our bearings. Now, I'm going to actually have to get beneath this to put the bearings in. So let's just slide down there, pop one all along here. And we'll see how this goes. Hopefully, we'll be able to get something fairly simple going up fairly quickly. Now, we are going to want these so that we've got a bit of a gap. Because I want all of the actual steps to be in the same location, more or less. All right, there we go. That's the first part. We'll temporarily put down, well, you know what? Let's not even make it a temporary thing. Let's plop this down here, and of course, because I am who I am, I need to beautify it. in some sort of meaningful way. We will have this. We will also have these as well. There we go. And there we are. Right. Okay. That looks like it has a place here. Now, how many steps have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4. We might actually run out. No, we'll just be enough for this to control just the steps. But that means I'm going to have at least 2 controllers to do everything that I am planning on doing. But that will come in a moment. I just want to make sure that this actually works the way that I want it to first. Right, there we go. And simply put, all I want is for the switch, we will be hooking up this up to a logic gate to control it. So I can control it from the top and, of course, from the bottom. But we want this switch to be about, let's say, here. And then hook that up down there. There we go. Very nice. Now, simply, we want these to rotate by reverse 90 degrees. But I want them, actually each one should rotate by 30, 30, and 30. So it'll take 3 steps to do this. Now this might actually be asking for a lot. Ooh, yes it will, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I can only afford to do this in 2 stages, unfortunately. So we'll have 30, then 60. So that still gives us something a little bit nicer of an effect as this is opening up. Each new step will start just slightly after the one before it. Right, so go. There we go. Perfect. And all the way up, please. Oh, that's grand. Okay, I like the stairs. I like it a lot. I want it to be a little bit faster, though. It's as fast as it's going to go. Well, poop. It's not good enough. But okay, I guess I'll have to try. I failed. Okay, it's a little bit of an obstacle course. I like it. We could even set this up to... Ooh, we could set it up with sensors. Imagine that. Just having sensors moving along. That would require as many controls as we've got steps, but you could actually have it so that the controls... As you were moving up the stairs would be folding out. But since I actually want a wall to fold here as well, it's probably going to be best to just do it with a switch for now. I'll keep that idea for the sensor-driven stairs in the back of my mind, and we'll use it, no doubt, at a later date. But for now, this is good enough. Okay, here we go. I've put a little bit of extra props around here or there, just to make this look a little bit nicer. But I don't want to get too complex with the stairs, honestly, simply because the more complexity I add with these sorts of things, the more times it breaks whenever I load the game in. So until the game is a little bit more stable, I'm thinking that I will probably err on the side of caution and take to heart the whole KISS philosophy with these sorts of things. Of course, part of the charm of Scrap Mechanic is being able to build interesting things. So I'm not going to skimp on the transforming stuff, but generally with large sections, I'm going to try and avoid making it too complex just for the sake of making it complex. So here's our basic stair system. I'm actually pretty happy with it. We can still walk around here without too much issue. I could perhaps set this up so that it has some sort... Ooh, that is a bit of a frustration. See, this is the thing you have to be wary of with these kinds of designs. It is painfully easy to make it break in some way. So here we are, basic stairs that fold out of the wall. It's all very visible, but that doesn't matter over much at the moment. And we've got plenty of storage area back here. This obviously denotes where the stairs are going to be expanding out from, and I'm just going to give it a little bit of a corner there. Back here, we can probably throw in a couple of props here and there, maybe. This is my cone storage. And also, let's get some wiring as well, just for the sake of it. So, some spare traffic cones, you know, all the traffic cones. Because you've got to have somewhere to put your traffic cones. And we would want some wiring in there as well. Perhaps we could even have the wiring moving along like that, which actually is kind of cool in a way. Let's pop these down. So we would have one wire. Can you rotate to face the side? Ah, there we are. And another one then, just going like this. And we want one more that just turns again. So there we go. Pop. There we are. That actually looks pretty nice, I think. We would need some lighting in there, of course. You don't want to be stumbling around in your spare traffic cone storage area and not be able to see what you're doing. That would just lead to mayhem. So we'll have some lighting just kind of snuck back there, just tucked in the corner, I think. And the same on this side as well. I'll rotate those around so they are both facing the right way. There we go. Quite nice, I think. Maybe even... No, I'm not going to put that there. So, should we have an extra box? I think we should. An extra box on its side, though. Like that. And then one there as well. Perfect, in my opinion. There we are. So that's a bunch of storage back there that no one need worry too much about. But it gives it a little bit of extra character. We can have some wiring moving along out here. Maybe even a fuse box as well. A big part of my build is just finding ways to make the large blank surfaces a little bit more... Well, it's not even a case of realism as much as it is just interest. I wanted to look interesting more than I wanted to look realistic. A lot of this serves no purpose at all, so realism is completely out the window from the get-go. So there we are. A little bit of a fuse box there. Running over to our stairs system. I actually quite like that. There are a number of things we could do. If I'd thought to, I probably would have risen this whole building a little bit higher up off the ground. So I had a bit more room down there and I could fold stuff under. I could do that, but it would require so many bearings because I'd have to compact it and fold it in on itself to fit it into the, I think, about 3-block tall area down here. Yeah. The odds of it getting glitched through the floor, and that's honestly the reason why I'm not trying something like that right now. The odds of it getting glitched every time I load in are just way too high. Now, that being said, I think having some folding furniture is a given. And I'm fairly certain that we can do a little bit of something back here to maybe fold out some desks and have maybe chairs that fold out of the floor. Without having to fold it in on itself too aggressively. I think that would actually be pretty cool. Let's have a think. How could we do this? Okay, there we go. I have finished our desk. The only part that I'm a little bit sad about is that I don't really have much in the way of options to get things to be on the desk. Like, I could perhaps have things fold out or fold in to try and look like teacups, but realistically, would you want a teacup folding out of anywhere? No, because if there was anything in it, it would spill. Oh, that would be terrible. Spilling tea is a crime, everyone. But there we go. I hope I have gone a little ways to making up for the fact that the stairs doesn't quite transform out of a wall. You can clearly see what it is by making a transforming desk that I honestly think looks pretty awesome when it's deploying and when it's deployed. Let's try that one more time. So the beginning of the floor folds away, the desk comes up, the limbs prop down, and then the floor folds back up so it actually looks like it's stable. I am actually remarkably pleased with that little desk. I'm going to probably have to think of other similar folding components around here, maybe some sort of, you know what, I absolutely do want a window here. So let's go ahead and build that, and that'll be the last thing that we do in this episode. It has drawn on, and I do apologize for the length of this one, but hopefully people have enjoyed it. Let's see, can we fit that in? I can fit it sideways, not quite what I want to do though. Can we get it there? That's not quite what I want. Can we have two? No, not easily. Ah, damn you for being an odd number. Is there anything else I can do? I mean, I can have a ventilation grill, but that's definitely not what I want. I guess we're going to have to build something similar to that. to actually build a window itself. It's not exactly what I was wanting to do right now. So I'll probably do that off camera and you can return safe in the knowledge that we will have some good lighting for when we're working at our desk. But that is going to be it from me. I do hope you've enjoyed this episode. As always, I warmly welcome any feedback you might have. If you did enjoy, then let me know in the comments what you enjoyed or what you would like to see in future episodes. And if you would like to leave a like on the video, it'll let me know that you want to see more Scrap Mechanic in the future. But until then, do take care.